are using. There are different sizes. They go usually 45 to 65 centimeters, so I would suggest steering away from the 65 unless you are very, very tall. Otherwise, the 45 works much better to 55 for average height. But we're also going to have some dumbbells here, so we've got 5s, and I've got a 5. They've got 10s, and then they've got 30s, and I've got a 20. So there's one exercise where we can just add a little bit more weight in this workout, which is why we picked some heavier dumbbells. If you've got two 10s, you can always hold two when we're only holding one. Or even two 15s. What I wouldn't recommend is holding like a 20 and a 15, or a 20 and a 10. That's kind of thumbs down. But we are doing all legs, all Swiss ball work, 5 exercises, all the way through. Slight changes, progressions, we're going to make them each just a little bit harder every round. 3 rounds total, so we're going to have a ton of fun. Ready? Let's go. So now we are going to get started. We have Jane and Annie using the Swiss ball. I'm going to show you modifications if you don't have one today, but again, check out that link down below so you can order one. So we're going to start right away with a split squat. So we've got the ball, it goes between you and a wall. Try to position it in that mid to lower back so that as we descend, that ball rolls up your back. Really good posture and make sure that you're keeping yourself upright and continuous contact with that ball. These are going to be 10 a leg. We're going to pause at the bottom. Here we go. So the length of the pause, you just need to ensure yourself that you have come to a dead stop. That's all we're asking for. It doesn't need to be super lengthy, but we do want to make sure you've got control on the way down. You can come to a stop and then bring yourself right back out of the bottom. One more here. Good. We're going to switch legs. Same thing here. Pausing at the bottom. 10 of these. When you look at your legs, you really want to be looking to see a 90 degree angle at your front knee, which will create a 90 degree angle at your hip, a 90 degree angle at your back hip, 90 degree angle at your back knee. So we're looking for 90 90s here. Good work. So now, we are going to go on to a reverse lunge with an overhead hold. So if you have that ball, you're holding overhead. If you don't have a ball, we're just using our body weight. And we are alternating between our right leg and our left leg. We're going to do 10 on each side, 20 total. This one should definitely start to spike that heart rate up a little bit. Good thing to mention here is what your core is doing when you raise those arms overhead. Anytime we reach up, your core has to aid you. So if you do not have your core engaged right now, make sure you put a little bit of bracing, a little bit of tension in the core, keep that back safe, and make the exercise easier.
And that is 23.
Good work. So now we are going to go to a hamstring pull-in. So Jane and Annie are going to use their ball. They will be flat on their back. Heels and most of the back of their calf will be elevated onto the ball. They'll go up into a glute bridge and pull straight into their hips. If you do not have a Swiss ball, we're going to do a glute bridge. So we're just going to hold, wait for them. The other option is if you have a towel and hardwood floors or the skill sliders, you can also do pull-ins using those. Okay, so now we're going to do a single leg RDL. So it's a little different version than I think anybody that even has trained at our gym has seen. But we're actually going to put our back foot on the BOSU, and you're going to extend back, pushing that toe along the ball as you reach back, allowing that motion to isolate to just that hip. So we're focusing on hip hinging, keeping a nice bend in that knee so that we don't compress any load into our joints. And we're keeping our back super flat, keeping our core very engaged. Very helpful if you guys keep a focal point as you go through a balance-based exercise like this. So find one spot, stare at it. Don't look away. So if you do not have the ball here with me, you can work to really try to extend your leg straight as if you had the ball, reaching it back every time you go into that RDL position and then bringing it back up with you, just as if it was pushing the ball. Good, so our last exercise is gonna be a sumo squat. So the ball goes back between your back and the wall. You're gonna grab either two weights or just your heavier weight in order to do these. Highest rep count here at 20, and we're working with a small pause at the bottom. Again, we wanna show control on the descent, coming to a dead stop before we come back up. Important, again, with our sumo squat, just because we have this ball in general, is to make sure that your back is staying in contact with that ball the entire time. So it should just be proprioception or increased awareness for you to keep an upright posture. Make sure that you're keeping your core tight as you do so. That core is what's holding you upright. So we've got halfway here. So we should always touch base on our knees when you're in that sumo stance. So you're looking to keep your knees in the direction of your toes. I have a fairly large turnout. If my turnout was smaller and here, my knees wouldn't be pointing out as far. So depending on your mobility at your hips, flexibility in your adductors, and your groin specifically, your distance or toe turnout is gonna vary. All right, so that's round one. You guys feel heart rate's up just a little bit, maybe a little bit of burn in the legs. Next round we go to, everything's gonna be a little bit harder. All right. Round two, guys, we are here. Everything's gonna get a little bit harder now. So, split squats, ball back against your back, between you and the wall, grab your free weight, whatever it was, 5, 10, 15, whatever that is. We're gonna hold it opposite the hand or the leg that's forward. And we've got 15 here, there's no pause at the bottom. But we still want to demonstrate control on the descent. So make sure that we're keeping our whole foot nice and flat on the ground with that good midfoot heel weight distribution. Big toe is down. No knee movement laterally. No knee caving in. We've got five more here. And we're switching. Feeling that leg burn here. 15 again. Again, all the same things. Check yourself. Is your core tight? Is your posture upright? Are your shoulders back? Is your knee staying in line with your toe? Is there any movement laterally? Is it going in to out as you go up and down? All that means we need to engage those glutes. We need to ground ourselves. Root yourself through that front foot. Good work. Reverse lunges here. So if you have the ball, you're using the ball. If you don't have it, you're using a weight. So I've got my 5 pound weight. Every time you reverse lunge and you step back, you're gonna press your ball or your weight forward. We've got 20 total. So one, switching legs still. Two, and working through them here. Same thing that we just drew attention to on those split squats. Think about your leg. Make sure that it's staying stable. Make sure that your core is tight and that we're not allowing our chest to just lean forward every time. You're shortchanging the exercise when you do that. Keep your chest upright. You want to keep your 90-90 at both legs. Keep that nice weight distribution in your feet. Adding a little bit of a shoulder workout, and by extending our force arm here for our core, we're getting a lot more abdominal work as well. All right, down onto your back. This is a very complicated hamstring pull and variation. It is very hard. So let me talk you through it really quick. If you're more comfortable just continuing with pull-ins, do those. Otherwise, we're gonna pull in, extend back out, and then we're gonna tap both feet to the ground. It's very helpful to have your arms out to the side. It's kind of hard to see with Jane's weights in the way, but if you take a look at Annie, nice wide arms to help stabilize yourself. Again, if you don't have a ball, you're just holding the glute bridge for the duration. Because because these are harder, we're also only doing five.
Last one
for Annie. Perfect. Something to point out is how they're doing a great job of keeping those hips elevated during that large leg extension, really loading glutes and hamstrings there. Okay, so now we're going back to single leg RDL. This movement's gonna look the same. We're making it more difficult by adding weight. So weight is gonna be in opposite to the leg standing on the ground. Other foot is reaching back, gliding right along the top of that Swiss ball. If you don't have a Swiss ball, you're just doing them out in the open. You can try, if you would like, to really extend that leg back behind you, just like you would be doing if you had that Swiss ball. Remember that our core is tight, as always, because we're doing something. Any movement, you should be bracing in your core and allowing it to help you allow it to make the exercise easier. I think I'm talking a little bit too much these two. Word out of them.
You're focusing.
So remember, trying to no Swiss ball, trying to reach that leg back with the Swiss ball, keep that toe in contact, and control ball with the push of the leg. All right, guys, so sumo squats are next. So if you want to keep that lightweight with you, we're going to add a forward press onto our sumo squats here. So we've got 20 of them, same setup as we used before, maintaining good back contact with the ball. Every time we go down, we're pressing our weight straight out in front of us. Again, increasing core load, increasing shoulder load. Step back with my right leg, I rotate alternating. If you can, Jane, I think we'll run into the wall.
Okay.
Oh, she can do it. Good. So, big key here is this is an exercise that will show you that instability. It's going to show that you're not keeping your weight midfoot to heel because your knees are going to be wobbling all over the place. All right? You're going to feel like your feet can't stay on the ground. So you can do a couple of things to help address that. Bring the weight in closer to your chest, or drop the Swiss ball altogether. Adjust your height. Maybe start a little bit higher up and work down into a deeper lunge. Hopefully those shoulders are on fire. You know mine are. Holding that weight out in front. Again, extended force arm. Keep that core tight. Yeah. Two down, three to go, guys. So back onto the hamstring pulling variation. Last time we tapped our legs to the side. This time we're going to lift our legs straight up. Still using the same tuck in and extension. Just alternating lifting legs. Slightly different balance component here by lifting up versus up to the side. Also incorporating a little bit of abs. Low abdominals on that leg lift. Once again, if you're not comfortable with this, just do 10 pull-ins, or do pull-ins until we're done. If you don't have the ball, you're on that glute bridge. Holding, squeezing those glutes, keeping your hips nice and high, core tight. All right, two left. Single leg RDL, guys, so you don't need any weight for this. We are focusing on creating a nice, straight, streamlined look. So when you extend that leg back, you're also going to extend both arms forward. We want to try to make a nice full extension, keeping or seeing almost a straight line, fingertips to your heel. That's what you're striving for. This is balance and stability. These are not fast exercises, but they're essential to maintaining your total body health. Hopefully yours are too. We just wanted to thank you again for watching, and please, if you haven't already, subscribe down below and share our channel with your friends and family. There's tons of great content on here, no matter what level you are at. We really appreciate the love and support. We also have links down below in the descriptions for the weights, the Swiss balls, any equipment we use or maybe that we reference in here. We'll include down below so that you can go check them out on your own time. Also put some great videos down there for recommendations if you're looking for something that maybe feels a lot like this video. We got them down below. So, thank you so much.